Faced with the possibility of 50 degree plus summers, experts are saying highly urbanized parts of Australia may become unlivable within decades. Already, heat kills more people in Australia than any other natural disaster, including floods, cyclones, and bushfires. Concerns are highest for parts of Western Sydney, home to more than 2.5 million people. In early 2020, Penrith hit a record-shattering 48.9 degrees Celsius, making it one of the hottest places in the world on that day. But that's just the air temperature. Heat from the bitumen car parks can push 80 degrees Celsius, and the surface of playground equipment has been measured at 100 degrees Celsius. The highest temperatures are typically recorded in low socioeconomic areas, with people who are vulnerable to heat. This includes the elderly and those on pensions who cannot afford to run the AC. This elevates the health risk significantly, adding pressure to our emergency services, which are usually stretched in bushfire season as it is. So how can we combat the rapidly heating climate? Experts separate this action into two categories: mitigation and adaptation. Mitigation focuses on reducing the air temperature. For example, the New South Wales government has focused on increasing the tree canopy across Greater Sydney by planting 1 million trees by 2022. While it's a start, climate professors predict that even planting 5 million trees would only edge down the climate by 1 to 1.2 degrees. Adaptation focuses more on urban planning. For example, building houses with insulated roofs and double glazed windows. It's estimated that up to 80% of the surface area in Western Sydney is sealed with roads, pavements, car parks, buildings, and construction that traps heat. Experts say that figure needs to get down to 25%.